Hi, my name is Scott Campbell. I'm a continuing lecturer in systems design, and I focus on teaching in the Center for Society, Technology and Values, where I'm also the director. So my research area is primarily the history of computing technology and computing in society from the mid, say, 1950s forward to the 1980s. I have done work on women in computing during this time period, how women were perceived, what their job opportunities were, how they were portrayed. I've also written about the history of academic computing in Canada, so the development of computer science as a discipline and as departments. Particularly, I focused on the University of Waterloo and the University of Toronto. And I've also done some publishing on the use of teaching history in a classroom, particularly towards teaching that encourages students to be more critical of how they interrogate knowledge and new information. So this is a slide rule that I use when I'm teaching students about the history of computing. And we give these away for free. We give paper ones away for free in the Computer Museum, which I'm a co-founder of here at the University of Waterloo. Slide rules really are one of these old artifacts that nobody really uses anymore. We tend to see a lot of people, alumni, oh yeah, I haven't seen one of those in a while. The math is integrated directly into the device. It's a very embedded artifact where it becomes an interesting teaching artifact to convince people that it's worth appreciating the context, the skills, the training that goes into even an incredibly simple device like this. In my history of computing course, I teach everybody how to use a slide rule and everybody gets it. They're not super complicated, but it really leads you into a new path into thinking about how technological knowledge is embedded in so many aspects of our lives.